Hey everybody, this is Tyler Baker, the pastor of Valiant Baptist Church in the Jacksonville, Florida area. I'm coming to you with the first video of a multi-part series on the subject of creation and evolution. And I'm going to be showing you that the subject of evolution is not only unbiblical, but it is totally illogical and unscientific. And the very first video, I want to begin with the subject of the fundamental question that all human beings will ask themselves, and that is, where did I come from? Where did the universe come from? Where did reality come from? This is the question about the universe, or the origin, excuse me, of the universe. The origin of the universe. Now, the scientific community's pathetic attempt to answer this question is found in what is known as the Big Bang, the theory of the Big Bang. The Big Bang, and I'll explain it more in detail in videos to come. So all the atheists out there, they'll claim that I'm strawmanning them. I'm simplifying what the Big Bang is, but ultimately what it teaches is this. If we go far enough back in time, there will be a point where we come to the beginning of the universe, and where prior to that, there was nothing. So they believe that there was a time where there was nothing. No time, no space, no matter. But then something happened, and it exploded. And the universe expanded to virtually what we see today of our observable universe.
About 13.7 billion years ago, this tiny singularity violently exploded. And it is from this explosion, this bang, that all matter, energy, space, and time were created.
Now, in this video, I'm going to deal with just the universal law of what is known as cause and effect, the law of causality. We've all learned this, and the most basic form that we've heard of this in is this, that every action will bring about or cause an equal or opposite reaction. And what I just told you, you probably had that memorized, that is the law of cause and effect. Now, this is not only a law of science, this is a universal law. This can be found in philosophy and all other disciplines or subjects that exist. It's, excuse me, just a universal law of life and of the natural world. It is the law of cause and effect. That is, if there is an effect, there must have been a cause prior to it. Right? If there is an effect, or think of it this way, if there is an action, there must have been an action prior to that that brought about the reaction or the prior action. A simple example of this would be if there is a ball rolling down a hill, someone must have kicked it, thrown it, pushed it. Something must have happened to bring about that effect, right? This would be the result. The result of a previous action. Well, the law of cause and effect is something that we just innately understand, right? If you saw a ball rolling down the hill, you knew that something had to bring that about, okay? You knew that. This is just a natural understanding and innate, just built into us. We just all know this. And the law of cause and effect, the fact that we understand the law of cause and effect, proves that every single person that lives today knows that there is a God. And the Bible teaches that. Romans chapter number 1 says this, "For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse." Every single person that lives and walks this planet and has ever walked this planet knows that there must have been a God. There is no other option. Do you know why? The creation itself. The fact that there is a creation proves that there must have been a creator. The law of cause and effect. There is a creation, therefore there must have been a cause that brought the creation into being. And we could look at this even on a more basic level. If you were to walk over to a cliff or some sort of natural wall and you saw that there was a painting there, you know that there was an artist at that wall at some point. You may not know their name, you may not know who they are, you don't have to see footprints, but you know that someone drew that on the wall. Why? The law of cause and effect. Now, I'm going to give you, in a more simplified way, the options when it comes to the law of cause and effect on how the universe got here. Just to show how basic it is to come to the understanding and to know that there is a God. And truly, as the Bible teaches, that we are without excuse. You have two options when it comes to the origin of the universe. So these are your options, your only options when it comes to the origin of the universe. And what are they? Number one, you believe that nothing created everything, which is ultimately what the Big Bang teaches. There was no time, no space, no matter. So number one, you believe that nothing created everything. Or number two, you believe that something created everything. Now I'm wording this as something just to be more simple, right? You believe either that nothing created everything, or you believe that something created everything. And of course that's God. Those are your only two options. There aren't any other options that you can think of, right? That's it. We're here. Reality exists. There was a beginning to the universe. The universe is not eternal. The universe, you know, we live within time and things happen successively. The idea that the universe is eternal is a metaphysical impossibility. The events that are taking place today have happened, you could successively trace back those events prior. If there was an infinite amount of events in the past, you would have nowhere to put today. So people will try to claim that. That's preposterous. It's stupid. It's just as dumb as the Big Bang. And all of us naturally and innately understand and know that this is not an option. Nothing is not an option. The only option is this. The only option is that something, is that God created the universe. If a ball was rolling down a hill and you asked me the question, how did that happen? If I responded and told you nothing, you're like, what do you mean nothing? Literally nothing. That's what caused that. Nothing. You would think that I'm insane. That is, it is the epitome of unreasonableness and just being illogical. It's totally illogical to try to think that nothing created the universe. And I like to explain this to people and illustrate this to people by two statements. Number one, I ask the question, can nothing do anything? What's the answer? Of course not. Nothing, and I'm going to abbreviate this, nothing can't do anything. I'll just end this with nothing can't. Put the ellipsis there. Nothing can't do anything. So it is impossible for nothing to create the world. Therefore, something must have created the world. It truly is this simple. Number one, and the other statement that I like to use to help illustrate this to people is that if there was ever a time where there was nothing, there would still be nothing. Think about that. If there was ever a time where there was nothing, there would still be nothing. The idea to suggest that nothing did something, that nothing created everything, it's to the point of insanity. Do you know what it does? The Big Bang shows how desperately man does not want there to be a God. That's what it truly does. It illustrates the heart of man and how badly a man does not want there to be a ruler. He does not want there to be a God. And why? Because if there is a God, if there is a creator, that means that he created you and that he makes the rules. And people don't want rules. People want to live however they want, and they don't want to have to be accountable to anyone. They want to be the lawmaker for themselves. They want to decide what is right and wrong. They don't want to be subject to the Lord. So they will literally go to the point where you ask them, well, where did the universe come from? You know what they'll say? Nothing created the universe. It's insanity. It is literally insanity. You know why? It defies one of the most basic, maybe the most basic, law of the natural universe that we live in. You know what it is? It's the law of cause and effect. And in the later videos, I'm going to go over many different scientific laws that even what the Big Bang attempts to teach, even the Big Bang just violates just very basic laws of science in general. So share this video with as many people as you can so we can wake people up from their days. We can explain to them just how obvious it is that there is a creator. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power and Godhead, so that they are without excuse. God bless you and have a good day.